And I'll hand it over to Krista Sievertson to do an introduction and jump into the content. Welcome, Krista. We're so glad you're here today.
Thank you. Hi, I am Krista Sievertson. I am the ASD and Assistive Technology Specialist at the Duluth Edison Charter Schools. And today we're going to talk about Read and Write. So Read and Write is a literacy support tool that helps students with things like reading text aloud, understanding words, research, and proofreading their work. So we're going to go through some of the different pieces of Read and Write. And before we jump into all the different tools that are available, I did want to back up a little bit and use our SET process in honor of assistive technology consideration, so that we start out by thinking about the student, then the environments, the tasks, before we move on to the actual tools. So what students would benefit from Read and Write? There's many different students would benefit from this extension. Includes students with specific learning disabilities or who have reading and writing needs, students who may be identified with dyslexia or dysgraphia, executive functioning needs, which spans many of our disability categories and many different students, and also English language learners. Read and Write can work in a number of different environments, including any learning environment using a laptop, a tablet, or a Chromebook. It's available for all of the different areas listed there. We use it on Google Chrome primarily in my district. And you can also access it from several different learning management systems if your school uses Schoology or any of those, you can also access it there. So Read and Write supports a number of different tasks, including decoding and fluency, vocabulary and comprehension for students who are working on their reading. It can also support students who are working on writing assignments, including their editing and reviewing of their assignments. Has research tools built into it. It can also be used for assessments and includes a lockdown mode that allows only approved features to be used, like text-to-speech. It can also just help to increase that independence for your students and promote inclusivity, because this is a extension built into their internet browser that they're using. If everyone else is on a Chromebook or on a computer or a tablet, they won't look any different than anyone else in the classroom, but we'll still be able to access those accommodations and supports. Along with that assessment piece, just a bit of news that just came out, CoWriter and Read and Write are going to be allowed accommodations for the Science MCA. This slide is straight from MDE, and they will allow them to use speech-to-text and or word prediction to complete their constructed response items. So this will be built in as part of those supports for students when they get to that Science MCA. So Read and Write includes a ton of different tools, including text-to-speech and speech-to-text. Sorry, my dog just started whining. Dictionary, including a picture dictionary, word prediction and highlighters. You can create vocabulary lists, including picture vocabulary lists. There's a spelling and grammar check built in, and translator, there's screen masking. You can simplify the text. You can also have it speak as you type, so you can hear if you're typing the correct word. And there's and some options for audio files as well. You can convert the text to audio file. And you can have students go in and read text and record themselves and send it to their teacher via email. It creates an audio file. So there's a whole bunch of cool new tools that are incorporated into Read and Write now. So what's new about CoWriter this year is beginning in July 1st, was new in Read and Write, CoWriter and Snap and Read features have been integrated into Read and Write for Google Chrome and Microsoft Edge. And CoWriter, again, is that word prediction. It's the best word prediction out there. It can figure out words based on phonetic spelling and, you know, just really does a great job of predicting the correct word. And also they've added in topic dictionaries, so you can tailor the vocabulary to the type of topics that you are writing about. They've upgraded the talk and type icon, so that'll look a little bit different as well. And when you go to talk and type, it gives you two options. You can use the talk and type feature that's built into Read and Write, or mine defaulted to just using Google Voice typing. So if that's what your students are used to, they can continue to use that feature within the Read and Write toolbar. There are also some new modes that I will show you kind of what those look like. So horizontal mode is up there at the very top of the screen. You can see the bar across the top. This will be familiar to anyone who has used the Read and Write toolbar with just a few small changes added to some of the icons. This toolbar sits at the top of the screen and is fully customizable. You can add or subtract the icons that are up there. And you can also move it around the screen when you're in an internet browser. Vertical mode, so this is different. So you'll see the toolbar over here on the right-hand side. It's docked over here. And this mimics the layout of the Snap and Read toolbar. And this is also customizable. And you can add in any of the icons from the Read and Write toolbar here when you're in vertical mode. And then finally, there's writing mode, which will be familiar to anyone who's used CoWriter before. So if you don't need any of those other tools and just need the writing support tools and don't need all the rest of that information, you can just do writing mode and it'll look pretty much like that traditional CoWriter that you are used to. So there are some more changes upcoming for Read and Write. So over the next year and a half, they are going to build the CoWriter and Snap and Read features into Read and Write for Chrome and Microsoft Edge. They're also going to enhance the iOS keyboard and the Read and Write app to include the CoWriter and Snap and Read features. So if you use any of those versions of Read and Write, those will be changing. If you are a current CoWriter or Snap and Read user and don't already have Read and Write, you should have been able to renew your CoWriter and Snap and Read subscriptions for this school year. The plan is to eventually transition everyone over to Read and Write as all the different features are merged. And our school district made the change over the summer, and it was a pretty seamless transition. We found that the price was exactly the same as what we were paying previously for just the CoWriter and Snap and Read, and now we get all of the Read and Write features as well. So what does it cost? So there is a free version for students that includes just the text-to-speech toolbar. So that is available to, it's not just for students, it's for anyone. But the reason I say students is because there is, for educators, hopefully you saw that there is a free premium account for educators. All you need to do is sign up for it on the Text Help website, and it takes about 24 hours for it to activate, and you'll be able to utilize that on your computer. Depending on your district, you may need to work with your tech team to make it available to you, but I was able to sign up for the premium account and get it pushed out to my account, no problem. For full premium features for students to access, there is a cost for districts. An individual account just for anyone to sign up is $170 a year. And there is a free 30-day trial available for all of those premium features. There is a group purchasability that's about $17 a year. And I'm not sure what the group size is for that. So you'd need to contact Read and Write for more details. But what we found for our district, which we have a smaller district, but for us, it was the cheapest option was to do the $2.55 per student in the district per year. And that cost came back to be actually much less than the individual or group memberships for us. And there is the option to do a free district level pilot. If you contact Read and Write, they can help set that up for you if it's something that your district is interested in. Did I hear a sound like a question?
That was probably me, Krista, dropping the link in the window for the free education.
Thank you so much. All right. Yeah. I just wanted to be sure. All right. So I want to show a quick video that gives us kind of the overview of Read and Write, and then we'll dive into trying out some of the features ourselves. Let's see if it works.
Read and Write helps students understand, engage, and express themselves. This literacy toolbar supports students with reading, writing, research, productivity, and more. It's a Chrome extension that works where you work, from Google Docs to Word Online, from learning management systems to web pages. Read and Write helps students read and engage with any text.
The unique geography of the Arctic leads to unique weather patterns that reappear in the region year after year.
Highlighting helps with focus and understanding. Customize your read aloud by choosing from a variety of voices and reading speeds. Dictionary and picture dictionary features help with vocabulary.
Noun, a mechanical device that rotates to push against air or water.
And Translator translates words into over 90 different languages.
Looking.
Screenshot Reader can read images or any inaccessible text.
Thrust can be produced by an engine piston or turbine spinning a propeller.
Read and Write helps students with typing, spelling, grammar, and expressing themselves. Co-writer Word Prediction shows students word suggestions as they type. They can even turn on topics to see more words related to what they're writing about. Talk and Type lets you speak your writing and have it typed out. He was the 16th president of the United States of America, period. Check It checks for spelling, grammar, and confusable words in your writing. Read and Write's multi-purpose highlighting tools can be used for research, organization, or studying. Highlight important information. And collect it into a doc. Or highlight single words to create a vocabulary chart with just one click. The Simplify tool removes distractions from web pages and lets you simplify the text as well as change font sizes, colors, or spacing. There are so many features to explore on the Read and Write toolbar. To learn more about each one, check out the Text Help Academy.
All right, I'm gonna try and go to the next side without playing it again. It always plays. I don't know how to do this. All right. So we are going to try this out and see how it works in real life, which is a little bit scary sometimes when you're live on a webinar. So we're gonna do our best here. So I have a slide here that gives you some ideas that you could try out if you have downloaded Read and Write already for your computer. If you downloaded it and don't know how to access it, what you'll do is go up to the toolbar, and actually maybe I'll switch over to my other screen to kind of show you where it might be if you can't find it yet. So hang on just a sec while I move over there. But this is a slide that gives you some ideas of things that you can do on your own. I'm also going to show you some things on my side as well. So I'm going to present my whole screen on this side. Okay, let's see how this goes. Oh, I don't want to do the infinity mirror. Okay, looking good so far? All right, so if you take a look at my screen here, the read and write icon is this little purple puzzle piece up here on the top, which I know is a little bit tiny for you to see. If you don't see it there and you've already downloaded it, where you can go is over to this little empty or black, I guess, puzzle piece and click on that. That's where your extensions are. And you can scroll down and see your different extensions. And I can find read and write right here. I have it, my little push pin is colored blue, which means I have it pinned to the top of my screen so I can find it. You might also need to click on the little three dots and enable your extension. So you'd go here, go into your manage your extensions, and there'll be like a little slidey thing over for you to make sure you have it turned on. You also might need to check with your tech folks and make sure that it has been enabled for your district. There could be a firewall or some technical thing that's keeping it from showing up. But I haven't had any issues having them enable things like this that are used for education. So hopefully you're able to access it. So as you can see up at the top of my screen here, I have the read and write toolbar already up. So I just clicked on that read and write for Chrome extension at the top and the toolbar docked right here at the top of my screen. And I wanted to show you first the co-writer piece of this and see how that works, since that is a brand new part of read and write that some people may not have used before. And previously my district chose, we had to kind of make a decision between co-writer and read and write, and we decided to go with co-writer because there's so many other programs out there, like built into Google. There is the Google Voice typing already, but we just didn't have a good word prediction program. So we had gone with just purchasing co-writer on its own, and we're so excited when we found out that this was all being smooshed together into one product that students can access in one toolbar. So to access co-writer, you go up to this little word bubble and click on it, and it turns purple so that you know that it's working. And I'm gonna make my screen a little bit bigger maybe, so you can at least see this part a little bit better. Okay, so you'll see right away this toolbar pops up and offers some possible suggestions for words before I've even started typing the words that might be at the very beginning of what I'm gonna say. So I'm gonna start typing out my So right away, I just have last night, and the very first word that popped up for when I put in N is night. If I want to select that without having to sound it out, because maybe I think night is spelled like this. So if I want to select that, I can either click on it or I can just press the number one on my keyboard and it'll automatically show up there. One thing that I like to have enabled as part of co-writer, and I think is really helpful for a lot of students, is not automatically put on here. And you can find it up here in the settings, and I'm going to show that to you. So you go up to the very top and you click on these little three dots and go into your settings. This is where you can do things like change that toolbar view that I talked about, the horizontal, vertical, and writing. But I'm just going to go down here to prediction. And I'm going to go ahead and click right here next to read prediction suggestions on hover. Because for me, one thing I found with my students is if they don't know how the word is spelled already, they may not know which word to choose. So if they can hover over it and hear it read aloud, then they can choose the correct word. So last night I saw And I don't know if that SAW is spelled right, so I'm going to... Okay, SAW. So I'm going to change it to SAW. The Aurora... I'm going to pick Aurora. And it's not showing up for me right now, Borealis. But one thing I can do is I can add my dictionary here. So if I'm going to be writing about astronomy, I can add some dictionaries. And I think I saw there was a second one. And maybe it'll show up now in my words. So I'm just, let's see, get out a dictionary. It worked last time I did it, but this time, of course, it isn't because I'm live in front of people. Last time Aurora Borealis popped up on its own, but you know, it's not always going to work. All right, luckily I know how to spell that. So within this one, there's a couple things that another thing, turn off here. Sorry. If you hover over it, it will read the word. If you want to turn off those numbers and just have clicking available, you can just toggle down here on this 1, 2, 3 area. Also, something that I noticed is if I switch over to writing mode and don't use word prediction, just write within the bar, there are a couple other options available. So I'm going to do that quick. I'll go back up to settings and switch myself over to writing mode under general. And maybe that's when it worked for me before too. So if I say it, and I've got to click on that little thing to have it pop up, it was it was beautiful. So now I have a couple other options at the bottom. You'll see a play button, and what this will do is we'll read the words as I type them. So read the words as you type them. So you can kind of hear back if you typed the words that you wanted to choose. It also has the option right here to toggle right over to that speak to type. So you don't have to use the toolbar up on top. You can just do the speak to type from here. And you turn it on and then press record. Hope I get to see it again soon. Period. All right, now since I started that in the middle of the sentence, I've got to do a little editing, which is a good, something that we need to teach our students. And it's also, there's some editing built into this as well. So if we go back to the toolbar, I have to remember how to get out of here. All right, back to settings. So I'm going back to that horizontal toolbar across the top. Just quickly, I'm going to show you some of these options that are available in the settings here. Students can change the speech voice like they showed before. And the voice is available often depends on your browser. So if you're in Google Chrome, you will see the same options that I have. But if you have a different browser, you may see different options. You can change the speed. You can change how it reads. And if it will also, you can change that option to speak as you type. So if you could have the student hear every word that they type. You can also hit, this is where you change which language the translator translates to. And there's quite a few different languages in there. All right, we looked at word prediction. So the next thing I wanted to show you is the read aloud. So here I have a Wikipedia page and it has a lot of really big words and difficult text on there that students may not be able to read. So for example, you would highlight the text that you want to read and you're gonna come up to the bar up here and go to the play button and that will read your text for you. And one thing that I've discovered is if you just press pause, it will, when this feature is activated, it takes away all of the other ones. So you don't get kind of confused in what to press. So the things that are available right now to me are pause, stop, and this hover speech. What the hover speech does is if I click on this one, anything that I click on, like over here, okay, so, yep. And honestly, I think it's kind of annoying because it just keeps going, but just know that that is an option if there's something like off to the side that they need to figure out what it is and aren't, for some reason, can't highlight it. But if you are in, normally when you're in this, the reading part, it will gray out everything else. And to get back to be able to use all of these other tools, you need to just press the stop button. So that's just something to know. You didn't lose all of those features, just need to press stop. If you have a piece of text that is not accessible with the regular screen reader, there is a screenshot reader built in. I'm having some glitchy problems with the screenshot reader on my home computer, so I can't demonstrate it today, but I recommend trying that out on your computers. This is the audio maker. This is where you can take the audio that's being read by the screen reader and turn it into an audio recording that can be listened to later and saved on a device. I want to show the screen masking because I think this is kind of cool for our students who may have difficulty focusing in on a whole block of text. And this can help just to highlight the areas that you want to look at. And if you go under settings for screen masking, you can also change, I should probably turn the screen masker off so you can see it. You can do things like change the reading light. You can change how much text is being seen and adjust it however your student needs. So this is the talk and type, which you're probably already familiar with. The translator button will take text and translate to different languages. We have the highlighters, which you saw in the demonstration, they were able to use to create like a picture dictionary. I've tried it out with a number of different words. It doesn't always have a picture, but it does have a definition, to at least the ones that I've tried out. One thing I also like this for is research. If you're having your students write expository, read nonfiction and write about it, and they're looking for facts and details. If any of you have ever used the color method of writing, we use the yellow, the stoplight method, the green, yellow, red, to highlight and pull the information over. And this totally fits with that method, which is super cool. I think the last thing I want to show you, because I think we're almost out of time, is the simplify feature. So what you can do is click on the simplify page button, and it'll take a page that has all that text and writing off to the side, which can be a bit distracting for students. And it usually goes a little faster than this, but my internet is slow because I'm doing all of the things I'm doing right now on video. But what it'll do is it will simplify the text, or it'll take away the visuals and information off the sides. They are still there. They're just down below within the text, so you don't lose those visuals, but it takes that away. And the simplify text button here can help take away less wordy text, rewords a little bit. There's also this new AI beta feature that you can click, and on text that's shorter than this one's a little bit too long for it to work, the AI actually does a really good job of rewriting the words and making them simpler to understand. And this is where you saw that they were able to do things like change the font and increase the font size and things like that. So there's some options there as well for your students. But it is 3:30. I can't believe it took that long. Are there any questions that anybody has about read and write or any of the features that we just talked about? I'm going to stop sharing.
This is really great content, Krista. Thanks for running through it. Yeah, anyone feel free to unmute yourselves or type something in the chat window. I'm happy to read out any messages that come through. Yeah, what else are you wondering about?
Shannon, go ahead.
Well, I was just wondering, now the version you're showing is the full paid version or the teacher free version?
This is the teacher free version. So okay. Which is exactly the same as the full paid version. And when you have the free version or the teacher free version or the paid version, both of them within your individual account, you can also add up to 8 profiles. So like I have this on my computer, but I added a profile for my daughter who doesn't need all of that stuff, like the research tools and things like that, but she will definitely use the voice typing and the co-writer word prediction and some of those kinds of tools. So I'm kind of set up a profile for her that way. So, and then I also set one up that's just the writing version, so I could try that out.
And your district pays for all your students to have this full version?
So we did, it's what we did this year is paid, it's paid per student, but because our district paid for it out of special ed funds, it's only available to special education students.
Got it.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Great question, Shannon. What other questions are out there? And if nothing else, I'll go ahead and stop recording now and want to say a huge thanks to Krista, except hold on one second. I see another question just came up in the chat. It says, does this work well with Kami? Good question, Ashley.
It's a great question. And I saw that it does. I was trying it out today and that I was running into issues with that screenshot reader. So I purposely did not have Kami do the optical character recognition to see if it would just work with a PDF on its own. And in theory, it is supposed to, but again, I'm having some glitchy issues with that screenshot reader. So I can't 100% confirm that yet. But they are supposed to work together.
Great. Another good question. Mm-hmm. Okay. I will now go ahead and stop the recording, but keep the questions coming. And huge thanks to Krista for being here today.